So welcome to the physics class, dear students. So in this video, we are going to study the velocity vector and acceleration vector. Okay. So first one is the velocity vector. So here, the average velocity of the particle is defined as the ratio of a total displacement to the total time taken for that displacement. Okay. So here, now to explain this one, I'll just consider a graph. Okay, the x-axis, and here we have y. So now I'll consider an object which is moving in a controlled path. So here I'm going to shift of path that is like this. Okay? This is the path in which the object is traveling. So throughout this path it may vary its velocity. Okay? So initially the object is here at this point, and finally it has to be somewhere here. Right? And just consider some position of the object or particle. It is the position of the particle during my observation. So here, if I want to say about the direction of the velocity and this position of the particle, so if I want to say that about the direction of its velocity, I just need to draw a tangent at this point. And that tangent is going to represent the direction of velocity of the particle at this position. So look here, I'll draw like this. It is the tangent. Okay, it is the tangent. So here I'll take this tangent as a velocity. So if we draw any case you can take, if you want to get a velocity of a particle under the motion, you just have to draw a tangent at a particular position of the object. And that tangent is going to represent the velocity of that object or the direction of velocity of that object. So here, I just consider it as a velocity vector v. Okay? Vector v. So here it is also in xy plane, and I can resolve it in two directions, along the x and along the y direction. So let me consider its x component. Look here. It is what? The x component of velocity vector. So I'll just write it as a vx I cap. Okay. And similarly, I'll draw one more vertical component, that is dy j cap. Okay, so this is what? The vertical component or the y component of the velocity vector. So now we just join them. Now, let's look at. So, object is moving like this. Right? So, here, average velocity of a particle is defined as range velocity of a particle is defined as the ratio of total displacement to the total time taken for that displacement. Then, right here, the average velocity vector, V over H, which is equal to total displacement. I'll represent it in terms of a vector, then displacement vector delta R divided by the total time T is in delta T. So here, delta R can be written as delta X I cap plus delta Y J cap divided by delta T. Okay? Why are we holding this one? From the previous derivation, that is a displacement vector. In case of displacement vector, we have taken delta R is equal to delta X I cap plus delta Y J cap. Right? So just a little approximation here. Velocity vector, average velocity vector is equal to delta X I cap divided by delta T plus delta Y J cap divided by delta T. Just a matter of factorization. That's it. Okay. So now here, where delta X means what? Or delta X I cap means what? That is the component of vector R, displacement vector, component of displacement vector along x direction. So it is component of vector R along x axis. And delta Y J cap is also the component of vector R along Y axis. You see it? Right. So now, instantaneous velocity. So we don't want any average velocity, we want instantaneous velocity of the particle exactly at this position. At this position, okay? Then, how to write that problem? It's given by how to write instantaneous velocity. What do we have studied? Instantaneous velocity is equal to limit of average velocity lying from delta T tends to 0, delta T tends to 0. Instantaneous velocity that are already we have studied in the classroom teaching, okay? Right. Then here, you just have to substitute the value of V average in your box here. So that is limit of delta T tends to 0. Instead of V average, you write delta X by delta T I cap plus delta Y by delta T J cap. Okay? Right. So now, so V is equal to, multiply this limit and go to plus here. Because these two are in the bracket, if I take limit inside, it will be applicable for this term as well as this term. So look here, I cap, I'll just take it outside from the limit because it only indicates the direction. So that's the limit of delta T tends to 0, delta X divided by delta T, okay, plus J cap, I take also from the limit because it indicates the direction. So limit of delta T tends to 0, delta Y divided by delta T. So look here, this term can be written as, okay, this term can be written as dx divided by dt. Limit delta t tends to 0, delta x by delta t means dx divided by dt. So into I cap plus limit of delta y by delta t from delta t tends to 0 will be written as dt signified by BC, so JK. Okay? So what it indicates then? The change in the position of the object along x direction means the displacement of the object along the x axis with respect to time. Displacement of the object with respect to time is nothing but a velocity. Along x direction means the component velocity along the x axis. So that I'm going to ask dx I cap plus dy j cap. Okay? What do you mean by dx here? Or dx I cap means that is nothing but dx y dt into I cap, which is nothing but component of velocity vector v. Component of velocity vector v along x axis. Along x axis. Right? Similarly, you can write dy by dt into j cap, that is what? The component of vector v along y axis. Right? Okay. So this equation is both magnitude and direction. Now if you want to speak about only the magnitude, then magnitude of velocity vector is given by v is equal to under root vx square plus vy square. Okay. How we have done this one? Again, one of the previous concepts. Just how we have given r is equal to under root x square plus y square. Delta r is equal to under root delta x square plus delta y square. Or else you can consider vector a, the very first concept, a is equal to under root a x square plus a y square. Like that, consider b is equal to under root b x square plus b y square. Then, if you want to say about the direction of a velocity vector, then, so this here theta is the angle made between the velocity vector v and vx I cap. Theta is the angle between velocity vector v and its x component of vx I cap. Then the direction is written as vx theta is angle between vector v and vx I cap. Then the direction of the body is given by v is given by so tan theta is equal to tan theta is equal to opposite means what? V by divided by adjacent, that is what? Dx. Vy divided by Vx, that is why theta is equal to. Theta is equal to. You bring the tan theta, tan towards the arc. Theta has it in tan towards arc, so that is tan inverse of Vy divided by Vx. It is about the velocity vector. Okay? Just take a screenshot and write it in your notes. Okay, next one is the acceleration vector. So just we'll follow up the pre-
previous derivation steps only. Okay, just to follow up as we have done in the previous exercise, as that is the velocity vector. Okay.
So here, following the exploration, the diagram of the same, we have changed instead of v, I have taken a, instead of v, I have taken x, and instead of v bar, I have taken a bar. Okay? So now, average acceleration is defined as average acceleration is defined as the ratio of change in velocity to the time taken for that change. Okay. Now, average acceleration vector, say average, is equal to the change in velocity, I'll write it as a delta v. Okay. I'll write it as delta v vector divided by delta t. So here, change in velocity, you are thinking about the change in velocity. Here, the change will occur whenever the object is moving x, y plane. The change of velocity can occur along both x axis and y axis. So I just write as change in velocity along x axis, that is delta vx, I cap plus delta vy, j cap divided by delta t. Okay, so now, that is what average acceleration, or one more step we can write, the factorization. That implies average acceleration vector is equal to, and there is a factorization, delta vx divided by delta t I cap plus delta Vy divided by delta T, J cap. Okay? So here, delta Vx means the change in velocity along its axis, and delta Vy means the change in velocity along the y axis. So where delta Vx I cap is change in velocity or a component of delta V through that. Okay. Is a component of delta V along x-axis, along x-axis. Similarly, delta V by J cap means it is a component of delta V change in velocity vector along y axis. Right? Now, instantaneous acceleration. We don't want to speak about the average acceleration. We want instantaneous acceleration. Then, instantaneous acceleration is given by, look here, instantaneous acceleration A. Vector A is equal to limit of delta t tends to 0 average acceleration. As we have done in the case of instantaneous velocity, similarly we have taken instantaneous acceleration. Okay. So just now write limit delta t tends to 0, instead of average acceleration as the particular values. So that means delta Vx divided by delta T I cap plus delta Vy divided by delta T J cap. Okay?
Now,
this thing is inside. When it comes inside, it will be applicable for both x and y components. Right? So that is why acceleration vector A is equal to limit of delta t tends to 0 delta vx divided by delta t into I cap. I'll take that I cap here. Plus j cap limit of delta t tends to 0. Okay. Delta Vy divided by delta t. So now again here the value of limit of delta Vx by delta t is dvx by dt. Limit of delta Vy by delta t is dvy by dt. Okay. So that implies acceleration vector A is equal to, so the value is dvx by dt into I cap plus dvy by dt into j cap, right? Okay, this is how we have arrived at an expression for instantaneous acceleration of a particle, okay? So here, wave, a dvx by dt is equal to Ax. Alright, dx by dt is equal to Ax. That means it is the component of vector A along x axis. Okay? Similarly, dvy by dt is equal to, I write it as a by, means acceleration component along the y axis, right? So then it is a component of vector A. You can write here I cap also, j cap also, okay? Component of vector A along y axis, right? And I'll substitute the value A instead of dv by dt, I'll substitute A value along x axis along y axis. That implies vector A is equal to Ax I cap plus Ay j cap. Okay? This is the expression for acceleration of a particle which is moving. So if you want to speak about only the magnitude, then the magnitude of acceleration vector E is given by A is equal to under root x squared plus Ay squared. So that is the magnitude. And if you want to speak about the direction, so then you can say theta. If theta is angle between acceleration vector A and its component, Ax I cap, then the direction of acceleration vector is given by directly arrived at theta is equal to tan inverse of A y divided by A x. Okay? This is how we can calculate the direction of acceleration of a particle. So take a screenshot and write it in your notes. If you have any doubts, you can you can communicate with WhatsApp. You can communicate in a WhatsApp, okay?